Guys, what's up? Welcome back to our video series on a crash course in econophysics. We're going to go through that first paper, just through the structure of it, and we're going to talk about an econophysics model of financial bubbles. That's essentially what it is. So here's what you got to learn from this paper. The author's goals of this paper are as follows, and this is just a quote directly from the paper. I find a model is tractable and at the same time provides valuable evidence. First, I demonstrate that traders always recognize bubbles with a time delay. So this is with reference to financial markets. Second, I study the properties of bubbles detection in detail. It turns out that the modeling of herd behavior and important news are major forces of financial bubbles. Third, I analyze news of asset prices and the relationship to financial bubbles. At the end, I developed some regulatory policy recommendations for financial markets. It should be noted that a number of derivations that I'll be going through in this paper will be skipped in this video. So there will be quite a bit of hand waving with the results, just pointing out the key points to take away. So the model consists of three equations and really a couple definitions. From here, the author proceeds to derive properties where his three goals are accomplished. The first one is financial asset price dynamic is denoted by PI as a function of F and T, where F is the fundamental price vector and T is time. He defines the derivative of this price dynamic with respect to time is equal to this benefit loss rate. The third point is that the second derivative, right? I mean, this is a very physics type of approach because he's going and thinking of this as sort of, you know, the classical definitions of derivatives of velocity and acceleration. But I guess AI here is, I guess, the acceleration of that price. And this UIK, this benefit loss field, right, which is from this second point, it's going to be defined with reference to high reputation and low reputation investors, where K here is going to be equal to H or L to denote those two different types of investors. So three definitions are important also for understanding this. The first one is the trading flow of asset I is defined by the amount of buy and sell orders, the number of trades of the buy and sell orders per day. This is denoted by this function of Q of P and T. Trading density of an asset is defined by the number of trades within a certain price range, where PA is less than PI and PB, where this is just upper and lower level, and it's denoted by this rho here. So this is this number of trades. This third definition is that there exists a relationship between trading volume, trading density, and benefit loss field, right? So we have this QPT, right, which is, again, the trading volume, right, is equal to the trading density times this benefit lost rate here. So it's those two here. This last equation, right, they go and they call it like a fundamental law derived in applied physics. And I'm not really so sure what this law really is, because, again, you know, I'm not a physics guy. And in the following subsections, I draw a model to specify this identification of a financial bubble. So in terms of deriving a key result from the model, the author proceeds to define the aggregate number of trades in the market as follows, which is the integral of our trading density over a range B and A, where B is our upper price limit and A is our lower limit. And the derivative of this is just going to be the difference in trading volume. This last equation, really, which is could be also our second equation here, since they are really the same thing, is referred to as the conversation law, where the number of trades in a certain price range is equal to the difference in trading volume. So this is all I have for this video right now. In the next video, I hope to go through the definition of a financial bubble, right, according to this author, and go through some other key results in this paper. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.